going to sound even better with the sun out, I think. I do love a bit of Jason Mraz. Now, we're going to be taking our first call on Alphabet Street shortly. I'm going to be talking to Channon Gray in just a moment. Channon is an author. She's got her debut children's picture book out. So that's exciting, yeah, isn't it? If you want to play Alphabet Street, by the way, you need to get in touch. You need to register. That's what you need to do on the phones on 0808 100 1039. You know, social distancing obviously is in for a while.
Oh, yeah, here to stay for a bit, I think.
I believe so. There's an engineer who goes by the YouTube handle Stewpot McDoodlepip. He's
just rolls off the tongue, doesn't it?
He's built, excuse me, a laser helmet to help others stay 6 feet away from him. So this laser on his helmet spins around quickly and it shoots light down on the ground, giving the appearance of a 6 foot wide circle around him as he walks
down
the road.
Terrify me! Blimey!
That's great though, isn't it? And also, half of us are planning to continue our newfound habits and activities in life after lockdown, including creating podcasts, online fitness classes, walking more often. In a survey of adults, 43% feel that they've changed their ways for the better and plan to continue with their improved behaviours once restrictions are lifted.
Yeah, that's such a good thing, isn't it, though?
Yeah, I'm going to continue drinking pink gin. Definitely.
I thought you might.
That's what I'm going to do. What I'm going to do, for sure. Right, let's talk to Channon. Let's see what Shannon's going to continue to do. Channon Gray is with us. Hello, Channon.
Hiya. How are you?
I'm all right, thank you. What are you going to continue once lockdown's lifted properly?
Well, I am going to continue, I think, making more children's storybooks, because I started mine all the way at the start of lockdown.
Did
you? I have a book available. Yeah, I started it on the 21st of March. So,
yeah, which was a new hobby. 2 days before lockdown started, wasn't it? Because it started on the 23rd. Okay, so your debut children's picture book is out. It's called Hi Germs, Please Go Away. Do you want to tell me about that?
Yes, so it's a children's picture book designed for children aged 3 to 8. And it isn't specifically about coronavirus, but it was inspired by coronavirus. I'm a primary school teacher and my class were really worried about germs. They are only 5 and so it was a big concern for them. And I kind of came away in schools temporarily. We shut down for lots of children and so I had a little bit more free time. And so I thought, why not make a book that they can access and understand and help them to kind of settle the anxiety around germs and the world around them.
And your lead character, I understand, is a hamster.
Yeah, he is. He's based on my Syrian hamster called Bear, and it's all of his friends. And they are wannabe scientists, basically. And they go around conquering the world.
Okay, full-time hamster, part-time scientist.
Yeah, indeed.
So, whilst it's called a children's picture book, but it is a storybook as well.
Yes, it is. It tells a story about the four hamsters, and how they have this big question of what are germs and how can we get rid of them. They don't like them. They want to find out what they are and what we can do to save and protect ourselves from them, basically.
Right. Did you do all the illustrations as well?
Yeah, I did. I wrote and illustrated the book in one weekend. I was very keen at the start of lockdown.
In one weekend?
Yeah, from start to finish.
Wow. You must have been working 48 hours that weekend.
It was a very busy weekend. It kept me very distracted around what was happening. And yeah, because I wanted to get it out there as soon as I could.
Yeah. Really,
so that children, and me especially now with the potential return to school, I think it would be useful for lots of children to read and have a look at to help, you know, understand why the measures in school that are coming up for them are in place.
Did you hand draw this or did you do it on a computer?
Well, I draw all my illustrations on an iPad.
Right.
And then transfer them onto the computer.
That's amazing. So you did all of that in one weekend. It would take me a whole weekend to do one picture, I think.
I think I was just a bit keen. I was very motivated.
So is there going to be a follow-up now? Have you got the bug? You've been bitten by the bug?
Yeah, I definitely have been. I've started work already on one that will take hamsters on a journey through climate change and have a look at some of the things that they can do, some of the solutions they can provide to help children tackle their anxiety around climate change, which is something else that they worry a lot about.
Yeah, so where can we get this book?
So you can get it on Amazon. If you just type in High Germs or High Germs Please Go Away, it comes up, it's the top search. You've got Bear on the front cover and it's all neon and very brightly coloured. But yeah.
It is. All right. Lovely to talk to you, Channon. Thank you ever so much for coming on today. Good luck with that. That's Channon Gray. The book is called High Germs, Please Go Away. And it is available now, if you'd like to get it, via Amazon. 24 minutes past 12. We better take an Alphabet Street caller next, I think. After the Fine Young Cannibals, this is She Drives Me Crazy.